Well, from murders to trials, unions strive to multi-billion dollar deals, general elections to government oustings. Standing on the front lines, reporters have seen it all. That is, until COVID-19. Well, this morning we listen in on the impact the global pandemic's having on some of those charged with bringing the stories to you.
Having to cover one crisis to the next in a matter of months, as a Cub reporter and also as an Abaconian, has really been a roller coaster of a ride, to say the least. With the COVID-19 crisis being the country's main focus right now, a lot of stories that we write are based on the pandemic, including the government's response to it, as well as how people are coping in light of this pandemic. For me, some stories are easier to write than others, but a lot of stories that I've written recently has just been stories of struggle and hardship, which are never, ever easy to write. You know, for me, like I said, it's never, ever easy writing those stories, but unfortunately, this is the new reality that we're living in, and sometimes it really can take a toll on you mentally, especially as we cover stories, you know, related to COVID-19 24/7. So for me, it's always a breath of fresh air when I get to write more positive news stories, like of individuals helping those in need in their community, or even when a person has recovered from the virus.
And I won't say that covering COVID is draining, but it can be cheating at times, because recovering is something that is dominating the news cycle without a doubt. And people do want to read up on it. And that is my job as a fourth estate, to cover and inform the masses. But when you cover something continually, repetitively, it can take its toll. So one of the things that I have done to ensure my mental health is have like a nice 2 hour after I finish work, just doing something like reading up on beauty or just chatting with friends and staying away from news.
It has been different. You know, it's a different story. It has been in some instances kind of scary, you know, because, you know, you don't want to catch the virus. But for me, I just try to keep myself clean, you know, wash my hands, sanitize, wear my mask, social distancing, and everything that we were encouraged to do to ensure that I stay safe.
So over the past few weeks, of course, the world knows that we've been covering this issue of COVID-19. Journalists across the world, day in, day out, have been forced to look at many angles of the story, how it develops, who it affects, and how it continues to affect society. And so, of course, coming in day in, day out, covering these kinds of stories can become very monotonous. And I know the impact we've heard about on the society. And so, as a reporter, one of those key things that I try to do to ensure that people get the information that they need in a palatable way is to make it as engaging, interesting as possible, sometimes as light as possible as well. I think when you approach it like that, it helps everyone to get through this issue. And so moving forward, while we don't know when the end to COVID will be, we do know that our job continues.
Working in this COVID-19 environment has been a bit difficult, or I should say different, because it's not every day that you would conduct an interview via a platform like Zoom. You know, our job is pretty much interactive, so we go out and we meet people, we interview people, and now it's like I said, it's different because you have to keep your distance. You have to now use things like mic extensions, and that's just not what we're used to. But it is what we have to do because we have to remain safe, and we have to make sure that the persons we're interviewing are also safe. We have to wear our mask, and we have to be on high alert. So I think that's what makes it different. But at the end of the day, we have a job to do, and we're going out there to get people's point across and get their story out. So
and as for plans beyond COVID-19?
I'm just looking forward to seeing my family, going to the beach, being able to hang out with my friends and stuff like that. Just getting back to some sort of normalcy.
So once COVID-19 clears up, the one thing I'm looking forward to is going to the beach. That's not work-related, but that's personal-related. And I love going to the beach. It's one of those pastimes that makes me feel alive. And so I can't wait until the Prime Minister says, all right, Bahamians, you're free to go. And so I'm looking forward to the day when I can actually frolic and have fun in spaces where I like to be.